Good morning. Welcome to Morning Prayer with Resurrection Lutheran Cooperative Ministry. As you notice, the scenery is a little bit different, and I don't have my collar on today. I'm on vacation, but that certainly doesn't mean that that Morning Prayer stops. We have some guests with us today. Pastor Neil and his wife Sue is with us also for Morning Prayer. And yes, Tom is here. Yeah. Say hi, Tom. You want to say hi?
Hi.
Okay. So we're here, and so you can join us, and maybe we'll show you some nice scenery while we're here also. I do want to tell you that Nyla Kogan is our new dean, and I ask, please keep her in prayer as she begins her time as our new dean for the Mission District. And also, don't forget, tomorrow is a very big day to vote, so make sure you get out and vote. So let us begin today with our morning prayer. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall declare your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Give glory to God, our light and our life. O come, let us worship him. O come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the caverns of the earth. The heights of the hills are also his. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. O come, let us bow down and bend the knee and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, and the sheep of his hand. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Give glory to God, our light and our life. O come, let us worship him. Our psalm today is Psalm 85. You have been gracious to your land, O Lord. You have restored the good fortune of Jacob. You have forgiven the iniquity of your people and blotted out all their sins. You have withdrawn all your fury and turned yourself from a wrathful indignation. Restore us then, O God, our Savior. Let your anger depart from us. Will you be displeased with us forever? Will you prolong your anger from age to age? Will you not give us life again that your people may rejoice in you? Show us your mercy, O God, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. And I will listen to what the Lord God is saying, for he is speaking peace to his faithful people and to those who turn their hearts to him. Truly his salvation is very near to those who fear him, that his glory may dwell in our land. Mercy and truth have met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Truth shall spring up from the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. The Lord will indeed grant prosperity, and our land will yield its increase. Righteousness shall go before him, and peace shall be a pathway for his feet. Let us pray. God of love and faithfulness, you so loved the world that you gave your only Son to be our Savior. Help us to receive him as both Lord and brother, and freely celebrate him as our gracious Redeemer now and forever. Amen. Well, we continue a little bit in Hosea and chapter 11, beginning with verse 12. Ephraim has encompassed me with lies, and the house of Israel with deceit. But Judah is still known by God, and is faithful to the Holy One. Ephraim herds the winds, and pursues the east wind all day long. They multiply falsehood and violence, and they make a bargain with Assyria, and oil is carried to Egypt. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And now we know why Ephraim disappears, the house of Ephraim disappears, because we've been reading about all of Ephraim's leaving God, but how Judah has been faithful. Our second reading comes from Acts, the 26th chapter, beginning with verse 1. Agrippa said to Paul, "You have permission to speak for yourself." Then Paul stretched out his hand and made his defense. "I think myself fortunate that it is before you, King Agrippa, I am to make my defense today against all the accusations of the Jews, because you are especially familiar with all customs and controversies of the Jews. Therefore, I beg you to listen to me patiently. My manner of life from my youth, spent from the beginning among all my own nation and Jerusalem, is known by all the Jews. They have known for a long time, if they are willing to testify, that according to the strictest party of our religion, I have lived as a Pharisee. And now I stand here on trial for hope in the promise made by God to our fathers, to which our 12 tribes hope to obtain, as they earnestly worship night and day. And I, for this hope, I am accused by Jews, O King. Why is it though incredible by any of you that God raises the dead? I myself was convinced that I ought to do many things in opposing the name of Jesus of Nazareth, and I did so in Jerusalem. I not only shut up many of the saints in prison, but authority from the chief priests. But when they were put to death, I cast my vote against them, and I punished them often in all the synagogues and tried to make them blaspheme. And in raging fury against them, I persecuted even to foreign cities. Thus I journeyed to Damascus with the authority and commission of the chief priests. At midday, O King, I saw on the way a light from heaven, brighter than the sun, shining round me and those on the journey with me. And when we had all fallen to the ground, I heard a voice saying to me in the Hebrew language, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me? It hurts you to kick against the goads. And I said, Who are you, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. But rise and stand upon your feet, for I have appeared to you from this purpose, to appoint you to serve and bear witness to the things in which you have seen me, and to those which I have appeared to you, delivering you from the people and from the Gentiles, to whom I send you to open their eyes, that they may turn from darkness to light and from power of Satan to God, that they may receive forgiveness of sins and a place among those who are sanctified by faith in me. Wherefore, O King Agrippa, I was not disobedient to the heavenly vision, but declared first to those in Damascus, then at Jerusalem and throughout all the country of Judea, and also to the Gentiles, that they should repent and turn to God and perform deeds worthy of their repentance. For this reason, the Jews seized me in the temple and tried to kill me. To this day, I have had to help that comes from God, and so I stand here testifying both in small and great, saying nothing but what the prophets and Moses said would come to pass, that the Christ must suffer, and that by being the first to rise from the dead, he would proclaim light both to the people and to the Gentiles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
What a great testimony from Paul that we find there today. In many and various ways, God spoke to the people of old by the prophets, but now in these last days, he has spoken to us by his Son. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets, he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight, all the days of our lives. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Let us pray. Praise be to you, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. There is no power for good which does not come from your covenant, and no promise to hope in that your love has not offered. Strengthen our faith to accept your covenant, and give us the love to carry out your command. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And Lord, as our country prepares to vote, Lord, we ask for your Holy Spirit to guide all of us, and that your will be done. Through Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. O Lord Almighty and everlasting God, you have brought us in safety to this new day. Preserve us with your mighty power, that we might not fall into sin, nor be overcome in adversity. And in all that we do, direct us to the fulfilling of your purpose, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom, and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. The Lord Almighty bless us and direct our days and our deeds in his peace. Amen. Well, thank you so much for joining Tom and Pastor Neil and Sue and me this morning on this beautiful Monday morning. The sun is shining here. I know it's a little colder there where you are, but it's beautiful here. So maybe I can bring you some pictures of the beauty that's around us. God bless you. Have a great and safe day. See you tomorrow morning. Bye-bye.